Hello, friends and church family. I greet you in the name of our living, resurrected Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We are in the Easter season, so let's be reminded that our hope is in a living Christ. Let's turn our attention for a few minutes to the book of Colossians. Paul writes this church to a people that he was praying for, a people that he was trying to build up in the faith, and he commended them for their faith, their love, and their hope in Christ Jesus. In chapter 1, verse 6, he indicated that he was pleased with the fruit that they had been bearing since they truly understood God's grace in their lives. Well, that's a statement in and of itself. Do we truly understand the grace of God in our lives? What does that look like? And so really, in this book, Paul is unpacking what this grace of God at work in our lives ought to look like. He goes on in chapter 1, we continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to his glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience, and giving joyful thanks to the Father who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of his people in the kingdom of light. Paul goes on to make this contrast between your former life and your present life in Christ. Your former life was filled with things that did not bring honor and glory to God. In fact, they often brought destruction even to your very self. And so Paul makes this point here and in many of his other letters that in Christ, we are a new creation, not just as individuals, but there is this new humanity that has been birthed in the life, death, and resurrection of Christ. And Paul is encouraging the Colossians and us as to what it means to live our life in Christ in this new way. In Paul's day, the Roman society was very structured. It was very hierarchical. You had a certain place in society, and you weren't expected to move from that place in society. This is not unlike the period of apartheid in South Africa. You were given a designation and you were expected to stay there and fulfill the roles of that particular status in society. So a slave could have been a king in a previous country, a military leader, a senator, a government leader, a simple peasant, but captured in war by the Romans, they then became a slave. That was their status. That was their standing. Women had certain status. Men had certain status. Children had certain status, and it wasn't very high. But Paul writes and makes some rather revolutionary comments because he is making the point that in Christ, we are now members of one body. In fact, he says exactly this in chapter 3, where he says, in Christ, there is neither Gentile nor Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all. In verse 15, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you were called to peace, and be thankful. This is the foundation for what Paul is then going to say. He says something very similar in the book of Ephesians, chapters 3 and 4. But here at the end of chapter 3 in Colossians, on into chapter 4, he then begins to talk about the implications of how we live life in Christ, regardless of our status in society. Paul isn't arguing for us to stay where we are. Paul is instead saying we have to view one another differently because we are all now members of the same body. And regardless of what we do, he will say in verse 17, whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to the Father through him. He says we are to do everything as unto the Lord. He says that specifically in verses 23 and 24. And in those verses, he's speaking specifically to slaves. Not that he might keep them in their place, but that he might help them refocus their attention on who they're really serving. They're serving Christ. We are serving Christ, regardless of what job we hold, regardless of where we find ourselves in life. We are serving Christ. And everything we do ought to be done as unto the Lord. I realize in the situation we find ourselves now with this pandemic and the lockdown, even with slight lifting of restrictions, sometimes it's easy to lose focus that even in this situation, we are new creatures in Christ and we are called to work as unto the Lord. Everything we do ought to be as unto the Lord. And if we can't do it unto the Lord as an act of worship and service, we need to question whether or not we should even be doing it at all. Our very lives, our interaction with our children, the jobs that we do, the way in which we conduct our business, the way in which we interact with people in the marketplace, the way in which we interact with employers or employees, children, spouses, family members, neighbors. All of this must be done as unto the Lord. We are new creatures in Christ. Let's live our lives in a way that glorifies God regardless of the circumstances in which we find ourselves. Again, please hear me. I'm not saying we're in a situation and we're never going to get out of it. We do pray for better things. But what I am saying is that how am I now in my present situation, in my present circumstances, showing myself to be a member of Christ's body? How am I living my life now, even in lockdown, in a way that can bring honor and glory to God? I pray that this is true for you, and I pray that it's true for myself. Let me offer a prayer. God, we truly do want you to be glorified in our lives. In a lockdown situation, in a pandemic situation, we want to show ourselves to be your children, those who bring honor and glory to you, regardless of the situation around us. We are your children. We are members of your body. Help us to live in such a way that you receive the honor, the glory, and the praise, and many will see and turn to you. Bless each one this day and each day. Grant us wisdom, grant us peace, and encourage us in our hope, for our faith is in you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Grace and peace to you this day and each day.